Hi everyone, thank you again for joining us for our introductory series to building web APIs with ASP.NET Core. In this video, we're going to take a look at HTTP and explore some of its fundamental concepts that allow us to share information between different places. Now, HTTP actually stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, and it was designed as an application level protocol for distributed and collaborative systems. Now, what that essentially means is that it allows two systems to communicate with each other, even though they may not be in the same place. One of the more common use cases for HTTP is actually powering the internet, which I'm sure a lot of us use on a very regular basis day to day. Also, HTTP is an open standard, and it was defined in a document called RFC 2616. So if you're interested in learning about some of the more intricate details about how the protocol works, I definitely recommend that you look up that document in your search engine of choice. Now, let's take a moment to understand how information flows back and forth when it comes to HTTP. The protocol relies on the concept of there being both a client and a server. The client being the application or entity that's responsible for generating requests for the resource that they want to work with. So as an example, imagine a user walks up to their laptop, opens their web browser, and now they want to find information about what are some of the most recent on .NET or Xamarin Show episodes that are available on Channel 9. So the job of the web browser is to generate those requests and send it over to the server using the address of the website. Now on the other side, we'll have the server, whose job is to receive that request, process it accordingly, and now it's going to generate an HTTP response that is going to send back over to the requesting client. The client then receives that response, processes it, and then now it's going to show those results to the user. Let's take a look and see how exactly you can compose an HTTP request. And the three main parts that we're going to look at are the request line, headers, and the body. Now, the request line contains information such as the HTTP verb it's using and the path, and also the version of HTTP that's being used for this request. Next, we have the HTTP headers, and the headers are essentially key value pairs. They contain metadata that's associated with this respective request. And next, we have an optional body section. In the body section, we have information that we can optionally send along with that request that might be useful for processing it. Now let's take a look at an HTTP response. And the response structure is very similar to that of an HTTP request. But you'll see instead of having a request line, we'll have a status line. And the status line is there to let us know, well, what was the status? What was the results of actually sending that request over? So was it successful or was it not successful? Did it fail or did it succeed? Also, you'll notice that an HTTP response also contains headers. And just like with the requests, these are key value pairs that are associated with this particular response that's being returned to the client. Next, we have that optional body section. And in that body section, we'll have any information that was either requested from the client or anything that's necessarily needs to be associated with this request that's heading back over. Now, we've gotten a good look at how HTTP allows us to send information between two places and how to compose requests and responses. In the next video, we're going to learn how to create our first web API using ASP.NET Core.